Master, why doesn't past masters such as Buddha, Jesus, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Guru Nanak, Moses, Baha'u'llah, Confucius, Lao Tzu, etc., choose to be breatharian?
Yeah, I guess it's the same reason, huh? Mm. You see, it's been arranged like that. Their life is simple anyway, even if they eat something, it's not that much. Just a vegetarian or vegan stuff, and it doesn't burden anyone, and it's not harming too much on the world anyway. And whatever bad karma, that this is nothing, you know, like 2% of the karmic burden only. And besides, if someone is destined to be a master, then he has to help many people. Do you understand that?
Yes, Master.
Let me see. Just one moment if I haven't forgot anything. Okay, the thing is, their food is very different, okay?
Yes.
And if they eat something of the world, they can liberate a broader range of people, more people. Yes?
Wow.
Because food is the biggest network of connection between humankind. Yes, for example, even vegetarian, it involved farmers and water irrigation person, the transportation, the labor who harvest, yes, and the person who clean it and pack it, the person who purchases, who wholesale purchase and then resell again, and cleaning the fruit and etc. etc. And pruning the trees, and therefore the food chain is a chain that connects humankind. So if the master partake in this chain, he can has more affinity. He can sow more seed of affinity between himself and the humankind. Therefore, the true master that teach Kuan Yin method cannot be a breatharian if he want to help the mass of people.
Yes, Master.
But you can be breatharian, okay? It doesn't mean I don't encourage it. Buddha eat even beg as he is not working to give people a chance to earn good merit. Okay. Food connect people, make affinity, otherwise he's a prince. Oh, I told you already. His father is the king of nation already.
Even though Buddha was reluctant to eat at all, but he did so that he can have connection with the world. He say, it is very reluctant that we even eat vegetarian food. Yeah? And remember Jesus also? When he was asking someone to give him water from the well, and after drinking it, he promised the person who gave him water that he will give her the water of life. She said, you give me the water, this water from the well to drink, but I will give you the water of life. You see? So food, drinks are a convenient tool for masters to intervene in the give and take drama of this world. It connects almost all members of our society, from farmers, harvesters, etc., down to machine operators, refinery workers, and even builders for storage, for road, for transport, you see, of all kinds, yeah? Storage of all kinds, and even weavers, container producers, etc., etc. All kind of related workers and networks for this nutritional aspect for human consumption. So as we consume even vegan food, we have to also practice diligently in order to have enough merit to repay the kindness of all the workers involved, as well as to clean the karma of the things that we use in this world, and to bless whichever trees or plants that give us food. But there are groups, for example, so that they also can elevate in the spiritual evolution.
Remember when his disciple Mukkinling Moggallana, remember when the Buddha disciple Mu Qianlin, his mother is punished in hell because she make meat to feed the Sangha and lie to them, say it's vegetarian. So his mother has been punished, go to hell. Yeah, and whenever she eat the food, even Mu Qianlin went down to hell and feed his mother by his magical power, because he has a lot of magical power, this man, and he always use it. But he died because of his magical power at the end.
Oh.
Anyway, he died because even if you have magical power, you cannot always counter other dark magician, okay? So many magicians, because they hate him, he defeated them many times, so they hated him, so they congregate together. They gather together, big group, and then make him die.
Oh.
They use also their power together to kill him at the end. That's why Buddha never encouraged anyone to use magical power. Okay, that's just by the way. Now, the monk, this disciple of Buddha, the number one magician, disciple of the Buddha, he went to hell. He used his magical power to go to hell to visit his mother and want to take her out, but he cannot. He's not powerful enough, even with his magical power. But he can visit her. And then he manifests some food to give it to her to eat, because she's very hungry down there. She is not allowed to be fed anything. And then he feed her food. And whenever the food comes to her mouth, it becomes burning coal, burning hot fire coal, so she cannot swallow. Remember this story?
Yes, Master.
Okay. I'm only telling you this so that you know how connected the food to humankind, okay, and karma and all that, because our world has already turned into an eating world. So the Master has to do the same in order to connect with people, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Now, when he came back and crying to the Buddha, after saw his mother in hell and cannot feed her, he cried to the Buddha for help, for blessing, to save his mother. The Buddha said, I am also powerless, because your mother's bad karma is too heavy, too heavy. So if you want to save your mother, you have to make food offering to the whole Sangha here, to the whole monkshood here. And then they will pray for your mother, then their united power will help your mother to go to heaven. You see what I mean? Food again, food. Yes. The Buddha advised him to bring five kinds of food and five kinds of fruit. It's a symbolize, the fifth level, no?
Oh, yes, Master.
So after Mu Qianlin brought food and fruit offering to the whole congregation of monks there, then his mother is liberated immediately.
Wow.
Now, you see the power of food here?
Yes, Master, definitely.
Yes, because when they partake of this food, then they partake of the connection with the humankind in this world. You see what I mean?
Yes, Master.
Including the mother of Mu Qianlin. That's why she's liberated. So it took a lot of monks, so everybody take a little bit of bad karma, so she's liberated.
Wow.
It's not because the Buddha cannot do it, but the Buddha doesn't want to sell it too cheap like that. You see what I mean?
Yes, Master.
Yeah. And he wants Mu Qianlin to be more humble, to respect all the monks around there in his assembly. Because I guess also Mu Qianlin, he has such a magical power. Wow, he's very, very powerful magician. He can go to hell, can visit heavens at will. Anywhere he wants to go, he can manifest anything. So I guess he has a little bit of arrogance as well, hey? Mm. Yes. And also to let him know that monks around him are also his helper, his friends, and they are also very powerful. Even if they don't have magical power like him, they are more powerful than him. See what I mean?
Yes, Master.
Because the Buddha always forbid to use magical power, but Mujianlin sometimes did not listen. So he harmed himself and at the end died with it. So that's it. So I want you to know the reason. You asked me why Buddha and other masters, as you listed above, do not choose to be breatharian. I guess this is the reason also, huh? They also know that food connects humankind in a network of karma, as in affinity, hey? Okay?
Yes, Master.
And many times the Buddha have explained to his disciples that whoever offer food and clothes to the monks, then we have such and such and such merit, remember?
Yes, Master.
A lot of merit in different ways. And he also told the story of past lives of some people who has now become strong in spiritual practice or who has become rich or has some special significance sign when they were born in this life or last life because they have offered the Buddhas at those times or the Sangha, I mean the monks at those times, some food or some clothes or some money for to buy food and things like that. Remember that?
Yes, Master.
Okay, so that's that. Now you clear, huh?
Yes, Master.
You clear why all the masters did not choose breatharian. Yes?
Understand, Master.
Breatharian is good for you when you don't have to be a master, okay?
Yes, Master.
Yes, and when you don't want to connect more with the world, and when you want to attain faster the higher spiritual level, then you dispense as much as you want with food or clothes or, you know, possession. Yeah? Okay?
Yes, Master.
Thank you, Master.